if you have a vector space V with the basis B, then every vector x in your space V can be expressed in terms of your basis vectors using its coordinate vector. But how can you find this coordinate vector? If your vector space is Rn with the standard basis, this mapping is implemented by matrix PB. And that's really nice because this allows us to choose any basis P for Rn we like, and then we use the matrix PB to find our original x back. Can we find this matrix PB? That is what you will learn in this video. So, what is the setting? We have our Rn with the standard basis, and then we have some different basis B, U1 up to UN. And then we know every x in Rn is mapped to its coordinate vector xb by some mapping phi b. Xb is given by phi b of x. And then the question is, can we find a matrix that implements this mapping? We know phi b is linear, goes from Rn to Rn, so there should be some matrix in between. So let's try to find this matrix. So what do we do? Well, first we set xb equals c1 up to cn. Xb has n components because in the basis B there are n vectors. Well, we don't know c1 up to cn, but that doesn't matter. Then we can compute x because we know the c1 up to cn are the weights with respect to the basis B u1 up to un. So our x will be c1 u1 plus c2 u2 plus c3 u3 up to cn un. And now we have scalar times vector plus scalar times vector plus scalar times vector, etc., etc., where the u1 up to un are just vectors in Rn. So we can write this now as a matrix times a vector, where we put the u1 up to un in a matrix, and we put this weight c1 up to cn in a vector. So now you have matrix times vector. We call this matrix PB. And here, on the right-hand side of the matrix, we have our vector xb. So what do we see? We have to set PB as the matrix containing u1 up to un, and then we have x equals PB times xb. So in the picture, if we start with our xb and then we apply PB, so we get PB times xb, we get our x, so that's how we go from down up. And if you want to go down, then you have to go the other way. So instead of PB, you have to use PB inverse. So in the R2 setting, we have E just containing of 1, 0, and 0, 1. And RB can contain two arbitrary vectors in R2. And on our PB, it's just a 2x2 matrix containing U1 and U2. So let's take a look at an example. Suppose our basis equals a collection with 1, 2, and 1, 3. How do we find our PB? Well, that's easy. You just plug in the vectors into a matrix. So there you have your PB. And suppose now furthermore we have some xb equals minus 1, 1. How can we find our x? Well, that's also easy if you have your PB, because your x is just PB times xb. You have your PB, you have your xb. So you only have to compute this matrix vector product, and it gives you 0, 1. So coordinate vectors, coordinate mappings from Rn to Rn are implemented by a matrix PB, and it is really easy to find this matrix, as you saw in this video.